In this simulation, we're looking at the behavior of a drug, modeling how it would behave in a body, and the simulation has options for either one or two compartments, and we're looking at the two-compartment model. And the idea is if we select injection, then we inject the drug into compartment one. That drug can then be eliminated from compartment one, or it can be transferred into compartment two, and this is the rate constant for transfer into compartment two. Once in compartment two, it can be eliminated, or it can be transferred back into compartment one, and this is the rate constant for transfer back. So in the plot of concentration versus time, you can see at each of these points, the drug was injected into compartment one, and then the blue curve represents the behavior in compartment two. Now each compartment is assumed to be well mixed, and then the rate constants can be selected, the values can be changed with these sliders, and the order of the elimination, in this case we've selected first order. Likewise, the rate constants between the compartments can be changed. The amount injected, the dose, the number of doses, and the dose interval are all changeable. And here you can see a regular dose interval, inject here, and then inject here, inject here. In this case, the number of doses selected is 5. The objective is, and it's not achieved in this particular snapshot of the simulation, is we want the drug concentration to be between these two limits, the toxic dose and the effective dose. Now, time here is purposely not given a dimension. Depends very much on what drug we're talking about. This could be days, for example, between injections. We have one other option here, and that is instead of injecting and getting this very rapid increase, and this would be, for example, a needle injecting into the bloodstream, it could be the drug is adsorbed from another source, for example, into the blood from the stomach. And we can select that option, and if we do so, we'll also have the option of changing that adsorption constant. So one other thing to note about this simulation is the area under the curve corresponds to the amount of drug. All right, so concentration multiplied by time, the total amount that was injected. So let's look at the interactive simulation. So here's the interactive simulation. So we can change the number of doses, for example, and you'll see then more showing up. We can change the interval between doses. And we can also change the amount that's injected. So the idea is for different values of the elimination constants and the transfer, we are going to get different behavior with the objective of trying to approach the drug concentration being as much as possible in this therapeutic window. And so by varying the constants, we have the potential to do this. And the idea of the simulation is to give you some indication of the behavior of the system. So for example, in this case, in the second compartment, most of the drug concentration is within this therapeutic window. We also have the option of selecting absorption. And now the dose, you know, as the orange injection is not as sharp because it's absorbing from a different compartment, and we can change that adsorption coefficient. And then you notice we're getting more and more of the drug concentration in the second compartment, the blue concentration within the therapeutic window. So the objective here is to get an understanding of what happens as we change these rate constants. As, for example, we increase the elimination rate constant in the second compartment, we can dramatically decrease the concentration of drug in that compartment.